My name is Anne Marie Stanzik. I'm a holistic nutritionist. You may wonder what nutritionists do. I would say we get people healthier using the healthiest foods. The way I like to think about it is everything you eat is either medicine or poison. So if you eat the medicine, it's obvious that's going to help your body. If you eat the poison, it's obvious that's going to harm your body. So today what we're going to go over are, believe it or not, the healthy sugars. And there is such a thing, it's not an oxymoron.
Very cool.
This may surprise a lot of people. I like to bring my neighbor Grace with me when I give this lecture. She lived to be 100 years old. Her name is Grace Payne. She loved sweets, but she never, in 100 years, became a diabetic. Now, you may wonder about that. The answer is she ate the healthy sugars because there were only two sugars here in her lifetime. Those two sugars were, does anyone know?
What?
Sugar cane, not, what do they call it?
Sorghum.
Honey?
Exactly. Those were the only two sugars she ate. Mm-hmm. Those are both healthy sugars, and that's why she never became a diabetic. So today we're going to talk about those plus several more. These are my handouts on the world's best sweeteners. Let me pass these out. We're going to go through these one by one. Oh, I'm sorry.
Okay, thanks, Emily.
Okay. I also have brought my cards and my brochures. If anyone would like to take these home, let me pass these down.
It is a big table.
A good catcher.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, you got it. All
right. Very good.
Thank you.
Now, a lot of people don't understand that. Let me just give you a brief overview. In the last just few hundred years, I would say 150 years, you can see what has happened with sugar consumption in this country.
Wow.
It has basically gone from a very low amount to an extremely high amount. This is very unnatural. Our bodies don't like it. Throughout human history, we have not had this, and it is most unhealthy. And the other problem is, if you eat the natural sugars, like the ones we just mentioned, honey and sorghum and others, which I'm going to talk about, this is what you're getting. If you look at it under a microscope, you're essentially getting a whole bunch of nutrients. You're getting enzymes, you're getting vitamins, you're getting minerals, you're getting cofactors, okay? You're not just getting the sugar. The sugar is most easily depicted as the yellow.
And you.
These yellow objects here. But if you're just eating white sugar, that's all you're getting. Okay, do you see the difference? This is what Gracie ate, and that's why she never became a diabetic. This, unfortunately, is what we're eating today. And that is not at all what our bodies want. Our bodies want this. Our bodies need nutrients more than anything, and we're simply not getting them. So let's start with the glycemic index. You may have heard that word before, but not quite understood it. I made it as simple as I possibly could. Every food on earth has a number from 0 to 100. I narrowed it down to just the sugars because that's all we're talking about today. First, I made this little chart. You can see glucose is at the top at 100. Sucrose is at 62. Fructose, which is in fruit, is way down at 23. And stevia is down at 0. So I first made it as a stoplight. The red meaning stop, don't eat these. The yellow meaning eat these but be careful. And the green meaning eat all you want. And I thought, okay, this is nice. But then I decided to make it more dynamic. And here, I think, is really what we want to see. If you eat the ones at the top of the glycemic index, it's like putting rocket fuel in your system, folks. Your body does not like that. Your body has to immediately stop everything it's doing, throw insulin at it, and unfortunately, then it usually brings it down too low. Then you start doing what's called yo-yoing, because your body is going to have a really hard time trying to stabilize it. So we don't want to eat the ones at the top of the index. Today I'm going to talk about only the ones from here down. Sucrose, which is our probably most common sugar, has a glycemic index of 62. That's like driving a truck. Okay, that's usually okay, unless you drive too fast. Okay, so if you eat too much, you're going to be driving too fast. It can be very dangerous. You can roll over, you can fall in a ditch, you can end up in the hospital, literally. Okay, so you got to be careful if you're in the 62 range. These two here are much safer. Fructose is like driving your lawn tractor or your lawnmower. Okay, it only will go so fast. It won't go any faster. You can't get on the highway with it, and that's a good thing. Your body likes to go slowly. Fructose is 23. That's beautiful. That's way down on the index. And that's in fruit, which is a natural gift for us. This is a gift from nature. You can eat fruit. You can eat a lot of fruit, like I do, and you will not become a diabetic. Okay, and zero is stevia. Stevia is not even a sugar at all. We're going to talk more about that as we go down our list. So that's like your little tractor with the cart behind it, and the cart's not moving at all. Zero. It does not move. Okay, so you can put stevia in a lot of your foods, and a lot of people who are diabetic should be doing this. In South America, it is used as a cure for diabetes because it will not raise your blood sugar one iota. It can't. It's not sugar. In fact, the chemical structure of this is extremely complex. They didn't even know what it was when they first found it out. I once was teaching a class, and I wrote it on the board, and everybody just looked at me like, you got to be kidding me, because sugar is very simple. It's only a six-carbon ring. Stevia is incredibly complex. They didn't even know what it was. So they called it a stevia side. That's what the quote-unquote sugar in it is, but it's not really sugar. All right, so let's start with our list. The world's best sweeteners, the first one is fruit or fruit juice. Mainly fructose. What does fructose look like? Well, I decided I should bring some of the ones that you may not be familiar with so that you can actually see them. Some of these you are familiar with, some of them you're not. This is fructose. It looks like white sugar. I got it at the health food store. Do you all know where the health food store here is?
Sure.
Okay, mm-hmm. Why don't you just pass that around? It just looks like white sugar. It acts like white sugar. I personally use it. It's wonderful if you're baking pies because it comes from fruit. So let's say you're baking an apple pie, a cherry pie, a blueberry pie. Mm-hmm. Perfect sugar for any of those. Absolutely perfect. Okay, and
same amount.
In fact, it's sweeter. So you can actually use a little bit less.
Okay.
But it's completely natural. It's from fruit. It has a very low glycemic index. In fact, when I make an apple pie, and I always use that, my neighbor, who's an out-of-control diabetic, if he's been really good, and his wife assures me he has, then I'll give him a piece of this pie, and he'll be delighted. Okay, so the fruit itself is a wonderful sweetener. Fruit can be added to a lot of things to sweeten them. The fruit juice is the same way. If you're drinking, say, a tart juice, like, say, grapefruit, which is very good for you because it's high in vitamin C, but you might think it's a little bit tart, you can add a different fruit juice to it, like grape or apple, and it will sweeten it to the point where it tastes better. So that's fructose. You can get it at the health food store. The third one on our list is honey. I'm sure you all know what that looks like. We're blessed here. We have so many people that keep bees. My goodness gracious. There are over 600 flavors of honey. A lot of people don't know that. It has a great variety of flavors. It has over 200 substances, including vitamin C, B vitamins, amino acids, minerals, including manganese. Now, you will notice on this sheet, anytime I say manganese or chromium, I have it in bold. Why did I do that? Because your body absolutely needs those two minerals, which are hard to obtain, by the way, in order for your blood sugar to get out of the blood into your muscles. I guarantee every diabetic out there is deficient in manganese and chromium and magnesium. So when I was working at the Dr. Labert's office, we would routinely, with every diabetic, prescribe chromium. That way, it would naturally and slowly lower the blood sugar, take it out of the sugar, put it into the muscles where you want it, where it belongs. So,
Could I ask you a question?
I'm sorry?
Could I ask you a question?
Sure.
Or do you want to just...
No, go ahead.
Okay. The magnesium, is that linked to being able to sleep better?
It is, but this is actually manganese here.
Okay.
Be careful. Those two are very similar.
Okay.
But yes, magnesium is a muscle relaxer. Okay. Absolutely. It's a wonderful thing. And most people are deficient in it.
Okay.
Stress, for instance, will get rid of it. It'll use it up. So if you're under stress at all, you know, or chronic stress especially, you might want to try taking some. It's totally safe. And see if you feel better. See if your muscles relax. And once your muscles relax, it is easier to go to sleep.
I have found that it does help.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. I take it myself. Yes. It's a very good thing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So honey is a wonderful thing. It's from nature. Everything I'm talking about now is from nature. Okay. These are not artificial. These are not man-made, which unfortunately can run us into a lot of trouble. All right. The fourth one is maple syrup. I think you all are familiar with that. Am I right?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Okay. Maple syrup is very good. Again, from a tree. How much closer to nature can you get? It is loaded, again, with the minerals. And folks, our diet is almost totally deficient in minerals, the typical American diet. So it's real, real, real important to eat minerals. So when it comes from nature, it has the minerals in it. It specifically also has the minerals you need to get the sugar out of your blood into your muscles. So these are all gifts from nature. Who knows how to do this? Okay, number five, you may not be familiar with. It's called sucanat. That is actually, comes from, I call it the real brown sugar. It's from sugarcane. I want to pass this around, and I want you to smell it, because it's wonderful. You all know how it looks to go to the sorghum festival. Do you see that?
Oh, my goodness.
Isn't that excellent? As soon as you smell it, everyone just stops and looks at me and says, oh, my. What is this, right?
Yes.
Okay, if you've ever gone to the sorghum festival, you've seen how they squeeze the sorghum cane. And what comes out the other end? The brown. I'm sorry, it's green to start with, if you ever noticed. Isn't that a wonderful smell?
Yeah.
You know,
I love that face. That's great.
There's a tree that smells like that. When its leaves fall on the ground.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that wonderful?
Just like that.
It's wonderful.
Folks, use that any place you would use brown sugar.
Okay.
Any place you would use brown sugar. Okay?
And it's, again, one for one. One cup or a little less.
Mm-hmm. And I have examples. I have some food examples to pass around with these things at the end so we can get a real sense of what they're like. Because this one, to me, is the best brown sugar on earth. And it's just like the sorghum. You take the sugar cane, you squeeze it, you get the juice out of it, you evaporate it and dry it, and that's it right there, straight out of the plant. Okay? Mm-hmm. Again, we're talking about totally natural sugars. And this one, again, has the chromium in it, so it's not going to hang around your blood. It's going to go into your muscles. Molasses. This is probably something that used to be used quite often. There's actually a brand called Grandma's Molasses, which I love, because anything Grandma used was probably very good for you. Again, it has the minerals in it, including manganese. This has the highest mineral and lowest sucrose of any sugarcane product. Now, anytime you see something brown, that's where the minerals are. Okay, think of molasses. Think about how brown that is, how dark molasses is. So you're doing yourself a great favor when you're eating these minerals. Sorghum. Who here does not know what sorghum looks like?
We are at the sorghum festival
of the world. So hopefully,
I don't like the taste of sorghum.
I love it. It's really strong.
It is.
Is there a
if you drizzle
kind or something?
Just use a less amount. Drizzle it on oatmeal. Okay. Mm-hmm. I used to put honey on cornbread, and that brings a whole new. I'd eat one half of the cornbread just with butter. The other half I'd put honey on. Okay, and it always made me think of, and I drink with milk, and it always made me think of milk and honey on the other side. Okay, yeah. But if you do that with sorghum, it's even better than with honey. Just a drizzle is all you need. Mm-hmm. Okay, these are strong, but that's because they're from nature, right out of the plant.
I made the mistake of using sorghum like I do honey with, you know, full tablespoon, and I can't do it. I have to go down to a teaspoon and then even a little less.
Mm-hmm.
So just start off with a little bit.
Right. Just
see if that's better. But if you use like a whole tablespoon, You're right.
Yeah. Okay, date sugar is something you can also buy in a health food store. These are dates. I don't know if you've take a look at them. You can get them at the at Ingles or any of the food stores around here. Basically, date sugar is simply, they take the date, they dry it, and they crunch it up and make it very, very fine and granular. So it has its own flavor, like all of these. Like all of these, they have their own flavor. It's wonderful in date cakes, if you've ever, if your grandmother ever made a date cake, okay?
Date meals.
Yeah, it's very good. Now, agave is something also that is coming more and more popular into use. Have you all heard of agave nectar?
I have, but then I heard
this is the color.
It's not as good as they were predicting.
I think it's wonderful. Look at the color. What color are we looking at?
Brown.
Brown. That's where the minerals are. Okay.
Okay.
This is a liquid, very low glycemic. I get the darkest color. And I put it in my coffee and tea. It's wonderful. It's wonderful as an all-purpose general sweetener. It's excellent because it has as a mild taste, I would say similar to maple syrup, but not as strong. And also the thing I love about this, again, it's from a plant. It's from a cactus-like plant, okay? So it's totally from nature. And this little mark down here, this little sign says non-GMO. Is everyone familiar with what that means?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, pass this around. And what you can do, you can just pop the top. If you've never tried this, just put it a little on your fingertip like I just did and do that. Okay, that's all you need.
You'll see what I mean about the maple syrup.
It tastes.
Do you use this instead of honey?
Yes. You can absolutely use that instead of honey.
Do you like it better than honey?
I like them both. I firmly believe in eating a wide variety. What do you think? A wide variety of food.
Yeah, come closer.
Because they all have different minerals. They all have different benefits. They all have different bioflavonoids. What did you think about the taste, ladies?
I liked it.
Isn't that nice?
I liked it.
Isn't that nice?
I've heard of it, but I never...
See, here's the difference. Sucrose, which is honey, which is fine. I like honey. Is up here. Okay? Yeah. But we're going from a 62 down to, that is 23. So in my book, that's a third. That's a third. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're down. So if you want to eat sugars but not become diabetic, you've got to pay attention to all this. Now, stevia, I have in two different forms. And by the way, if you ever go get coffee at Starbucks or any place like that, be careful what you put in it, okay? They have choices, and look for them. One of them is often honey. That's fine. But another one, we're backing up a minute to number, probably number five, very similar to sucanat, is sugar in the raw, okay? See those? That's what they'll often have if you're going to buy coffee out in the world somewhere. So choose the good thing, not the bad thing. The last one is stevia. Stevia, like I said, is not a sugar at all. It comes as a liquid or as a solid in little packs. Okay. Zero glycemic index. You can put it in your coffee and tea. I like it to sweeten things that are kind of tart or sour. Like, for instance, back again to grapefruit juice. Okay. You put a few drops of this in grapefruit juice, sweetens it right up. It's fabulous. It's very nice. And I want you to be careful of one thing, however, because there is, I think, something that's a little deceptive on the market right now. This is the good one. This is the one that I brought. See the dark green label? Okay, if you read it, it's just inulin, which is a fiber, and stevia. That's great. In fact, inulin helps the cells of your large intestine, so it's a good thing. However, what's on the market right now, oh, there it is, inulin and stevia leaf extract. Okay, I blew it up so you could read it. And it correctly says zero calories, zero glycemic index. I agree. However, what is also on the market is not good. This is called stevia in the raw. You would think that is a good food. It is not. This should not be on the market, in my opinion. Why? Because nowhere does it say zero glycemic index. Because the first ingredient is dextrose. Does anybody know what dextrose is?
Sugar.
Type of sugar.
What kind?
Don't know.
The top of cups?
That one. That one. Okay, so why is this on the market? I don't know, folks. And if I had all the time and money in the world, I would get it off the market. So you've got to read your labels. This is the good one. You get it at a health food store. Okay, don't be deceived and get this one. This is not a good one. Because you can see right there, first ingredient, dextrose. It's the same thing as glucose. Okay, they're just using a different name.
So it's really not stevia.
This is the good, well, they do have some stevia extract as the second ingredient.
Yeah.
But by law, every food that you buy in the store has to have what's the largest volume listed first. So this actually has more dextrose than it does stevia. Mm-hmm. So why are they calling it stevia? I don't know. Okay? To get you to buy it, I guess.
Yeah. Well, yeah, because that's what you hear is stevia, stevia, stevia. Mm-hmm. So
that's why I'm...
When you see that, that's what you're going to grab.
Exactly.
And you're not going to read the ingredients because that's what you've heard.
Well, this is my job. This is why I'm here to clarify things.
Yes.
So this is the one you want. That's the good one. You can use a little pack like that in your sugar, in as sugar in your coffee or tea.
So where do we get the good one? Is it sold?
It's a health food store.
Is it health food store? Yeah.
Okay.
And they have the liquid also. So whatever one you want is good. Okay. Let me just see. I think I also need to make another point here to kind of clarify what I've just said. Look for things found in nature. Before you put a food in your mouth, is it found in nature? Ask yourself, okay? The sugars that we just talked about, I mentioned again and again and again how they are found in nature, how they come from plants, how they were put there for us. So if it's found in nature, go ahead and eat it. But if it's made in a laboratory by humans, be very careful. Be very careful. And that includes all the artificial sweeteners. I wouldn't put any of them in my body. No. So that's your first question. Is it found in nature? Your second question is, has it been eaten for a long, long time? Okay? Like I just mentioned, grandma's molasses. Okay? Yeah. Have your grandparents eaten it? Use the grandfather clock, not the cuckoo clock. Okay? I'm very serious about this, folks. I'm very serious. They're coming up with all kinds of new foods they're trying to tell you are good, and they're not. So ask yourself these two questions before you eat anything. Is it found in nature, and has it been eaten for a long, long time? And then you're probably going to be quite safe. All right. I did bring some samples. Because I believe that if you eat the healthy sugars and or fruit, you will be satisfied with eating sweets that are actually good for you. Then you won't crave more sweets because you will be satisfied. What I did this morning, and I love recipes like this. I try to make things very easy for people. This recipe has two ingredients.
There you go.
Could it be easier?
Yes, yeah.
It took me 10 minutes to make these.
Yeah. Even better.
Okay, 10 minutes.
Yeah.
You all might recognize these. These are chocolate-covered strawberries. Okay, I'm going to pass them around. Help yourself. The fruit is the sweet. Okay, and it's a very good sweet. What kind of chocolate did I use? Oh, I also have some napkins you might want. Here, if you could pass those around. This is the chocolate that I used. I used 70% Lindt, which I find to be an extremely high-quality chocolate. The higher this number, the more chocolate, the less sugar. Mm. Okay? Have more than one. Feel free. What do you think?
Good.
Delicious. Satisfying. Absolutely delicious.
These are organic strawberries. They have a real strawberry taste.
Right.
Okay. But I would suggest getting at least, if you're going to eat chocolate, at least 60%, if not higher. I have friends who started at 60. That became too sweet. They went to 70. Now that's too sweet for them. Now they eat the 80%.
Now that has, what kind of sweetener in there?
This does have white sugar in it, but very little. That's what I was saying. More and more chocolate. Less and less sugar.
And what's the brand of that again, Anne-Marie?
This is Lindt.
They have that at Ingles.
Yes, they do, and it's excellent. It's probably not from this country, I would guess. Yeah, chocolates are
I have another one, thank you.
They're very variable, right? You know, once you start eating them, they become very addictive. But it's in small amounts, they're wonderful. Okay? So we're eating very little chocolate here if you look at it. The chocolate is only coating the berry. Mm-hmm. 80%, maybe 85% of what you're eating is fruit, which is very sweet and very satisfying. Okay.
Delicious.
Another thing that I wanted to show you with fruit.
Lovely.
These are cold sacks. They're very nice. If you have something cold, they'll keep it cold. This, by the way, cinnamon. Does anybody know what the benefits of cinnamon are?
Mm, I love it.
The benefits?
The benefits.
Does it kind of increase your metabolism? Because it's kind of like, get your blood going.
No. Actually, I was thinking of lowering two things that you like lowered. One is blood sugar and one is cholesterol.
Ooh, nice. Great. Wonderful. Mm.
This is Stonyfield organic yogurt. Mm. It's wonderful. They've been in business a long time. This is plain yogurt, I just want to point out. And what I'm going to do is put some in a bowl. Now, again, this is... If someone could time me how many minutes this is taking, it's going to be less than three. Okay? I have some spoons I wanted to pass out. What we'll do is, everybody, here, can you pass these out? Give everybody a spoon. So far, all we have is yogurt. I bought some nice grapes and washed them. And by the way, when you eat grapes, folks, the ones that are the darkest color have the most antioxidants. Okay, so if you have a choice of green or light red or dark red or the really dark purple, I would suggest getting the darkest ones available. Okay, because the darker they are, the more antioxidants you're going to have. We all need antioxidants.
Purple ones, those are so good.
Do they come seedless now?
Oh, these are all seedless.
No, yeah. Dark purple.
Yeah, I believe so.
Yeah, they're delicious.
Okay, so far I probably used up about 2 minutes. All I've done is taken the plain yogurt, by the way, folks. You don't want the ones with the sweetener in it, okay?
No, that's...
Because it's way too sweet.
Yeah.
So, put some grapes and sprinkle it with cinnamon, okay? I did this when I was working for Dr. Leiber. I made these little things for everybody. And she came running out of her office and went, "This is wonderful." And I said, "I know."
But thanks.
Okay, you two can share this one.
Aww, I love that.
Okay.
I am loving this chocolate and strawberries and more food. This is awesome, yeah. Amory. Thank you.
We're not done yet. I have one more thing.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, let's get the reactions here. Did you hear that, folks? Did you hear what was just said?
Yummy.
Okay.
I love that.
This is yogurt, folks. It's very tart when you think about it. Mm-hmm. Okay?
I would have never put cinnamon on my yogurt.
I wouldn't either. It was delicious. That is
cinnamon
really good.
Cinnamon goes wonderful on fruit.
And with grapes, I would never
put it. I never would have thought about that.
Well, this is my job. To show you how to eat food that is really good and really satisfying so that you don't have to eat the food that is not good and not satisfying. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is an organic apple that I got at Ingles. I highly recommend organic apples because apples are sprayed 22 times if they're not organic. That's, in my opinion, that's too many times.
Yeah, that's way up there.
Yes, and we know that a lot of the insecticides are carcinogens. Okay, so do yourself a favor. In my opinion, you don't need to be eating them.
Which variety is that?
I believe this is a Fuji.
Oh, that's my favorite.
I know, aren't they wonderful? I have 15 apple trees on my property that I planted.
Wow.
You can grow apples very easily here, folks. Apples, pears, blueberries, blackberries, peaches. I would recommend everybody growing as much of their own food as possible.
Right.
Now, this is a simple thing I made with sucanat. Remember sucanat?
Mm-hmm.
Everyone smelled recently?
The brown sugar.
Mm-hmm. Brown sugar. Yes, the real brown sugar. All I'm doing is taking an apple. I'm going to I guess I'll just put them in here. And we'll do it like we did in culinary. Just use your fingers to kind of grab a hold of the apple. This is simply a great use for Sucanat. It makes a beautiful caramel, okay? Mm. All you do is I took 3 tablespoons of Sucanat, put it in a frying pan, and the double the amount of organic whipped cream. And then you cook it until it bubbles. And as soon as it starts bubbling, you take it off the heat, let it sit until it cools a little bit. It'll thicken as it cools. And you might think, wow, you're using sugar and cream. That doesn't sound, you know, maybe not real healthy. But again, like the chocolate-covered strawberries, it's just a coating. Most of what you're eating is apple, is fruit. Mm-hmm. Okay? I'm going to pass this around. Just do the best you can. You've got napkins. Just take a piece, dredge it in the caramel, and eat it, and tell me what you think. This is one of my favorite desserts. Again, 3 ingredients. Mm-hmm. Did you hear that? Did you hear that?
That's the best.
Isn't it? It's real caramel. Why? Because it came from Sucanat. What do you think, Jude?
That is really good.
Isn't that amazing?
It tastes fresh. That wonderful smell. It doesn't taste like that stuff out of a jar.
Exactly.
It tastes fresh.
I made it this morning.
So was the Sucanat with whipped cream, organic whipped cream?
In the frying pan. Right. You put half the amount of Sucanat, double whatever that is, of the whipped cream. So okay. I used 3 tablespoons of the Sucanat, 6 of the whipped cream. For 2 people, probably 2 and 4 would be fine. 2 of the Sucanat, 4 of the whipped cream. Mix it with it'll bubble. It will start to bubble, and it will turn dark. It'll turn that color, that caramel color. Okay?
That is
as soon as it starts to really bubble, just turn the gas off, take it off the gas, you're done. We're talking a total of maybe 5 minutes cooking time, if that. And then it took me maybe a minute to cut the apple. So, folks, this is real easy. This is real easy. This is a wonderful winter dessert. Because basically, it's an easier way to eat a caramel apple. It's real caramel. Mm-hmm. And it's not sticking to your teeth and pulling your teeth out.
Right. Having to go to the dentist.
Right. And this is real food for real people. And that's basically what I like to show people how to do in very easy terms. Very easy. Okay?
If I must.
So, I think.
Thank you.
I think one more thing I'll mention, and that is this sugar at the top of the index, glucose, okay? Believe it or not, you get that from white bread, white rice, and white noodles. So I have a whole other talk on whole grains, which we all should be eating. It's very easy to tell the difference, white versus brown. The whole grains are brown, okay? Mm-hmm. So this is not found in nature. This was made by man because man made white bread. 100 years ago, we did not have white bread. Nobody had white bread. It didn't exist, okay? So the problem is this. When you're eating white bread, what you're really eating is a candy bar.
Yeah.
Okay? And once people understand that, it's just taking your blood sugar and shooting it to the moon. 100 on the glycemic index. Okay?
Sick.
So you think you're eating this, what you're really eating is that, okay? I like to be very visual because this is how people learn.
It doesn't even look good.
Right, exactly. It doesn't look good. It does not look good. Okay, so keep that in mind. Let me just go back to, is it found in nature? Has it been eaten for a long time? Okay, folks, any questions at this point?
That's wonderful.
Very good. Very good.
Yeah. This is what I do. I meet with people individually. I teach classes. I, for 6 years, worked with a doctor. I was in charge of a program where we lowered people's weight, blood sugar, blood pressure, and cholesterol. And it was very well done.
Yeah. Fantastic.
People change their lives and change how they look. So when people say, what do? I say, well, I eat for a living. And I also get to watch people become younger, healthier, and more beautiful.
Yeah.
It's a nice job.
Yeah, that's wonderful. Now, if people wanted to contact you, Anne Marie, to get classes or find information, what's the best way to contact you?
My phone number on my card.
Okay.
You have one?
I do.
Okay.
I just wanted to have that for the viewers that would be watching by YouTube or internet. So it's 706-745-7900.
Correct.
Okay, very good.
Yes, because I like to have a conversation with people. I love it when people call me and we can talk on the phone. It's very hard to talk on social media, usually.
Right.
So I like to have conversations. I like to really communicate with people.
Good.
Do you have classes one-on-one or do you prefer them in a group, like if we had a class or if we wanted personal?
I typically, when I meet with a person one-on-one, it's usually to address their issues. So I tailor it to what they need. So I wouldn't necessarily call it a class, I'd call it a meeting. A class, by definition, is usually a larger group. But I do both.
Mm-hmm. But like you say, you're a consultant.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, exactly. Yeah. And it's really important for people to eat right. Mm-hmm. More so than they realize. Okay. More so than everyone realizes it. But once you start eating right and you tasted how natural all that tastes, mm-hmm. how good it tastes, mm-hmm. what that is your body's saying yes. Mm-hmm. Your body is saying yes to that because mm-hmm. your body knows what's natural. When you're eating the unnatural foods, the artificial foods, okay, the FDC colors, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Your body's saying, literally, I don't know what this is.
Exactly.
I don't know what this is. I can't break it down. Mm-hmm. So what happens? You gain weight because mm-hmm. your body's treating it as a toxin. Your immune system attacks it. Then what? You get body-wide inflammation. You can't get rid of it because you can't break it down. Mm-hmm. Okay? So my advice is go back to all the stuff that's natural. It just makes perfect sense.
Very okay? good. Okay.
Any questions at this point?
You need some more of that.
You remember yes, how to do the recipes now, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
You got it. Right? Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, Anne Marie. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for this opportunity.
You're welcome. Thank you for coming.